getting a Wheel of Fortune commercial advertisement with Vanna White in that post Disney thing.
So many of us have grown up with Disney, and we always thought of the Disney parks, but there's so much more than that. There are adventures by Disney where vacationers can experience some of the great American cities, but also foreign destinations as well. There is the Disney Cruise Line with magnificent ships.
Disney and Wheel, no fun. That's K-N-O-W.
There is Hawani in Hawaii.
What I love about the Hawani is it has a Disney touch, and yet it's authentic Hawaiian, which I think is terrific.
I know there's so many great things to do here, too. The water is just beautiful.
It's very nice. She's not going
to
hotel. Yeah, we know that's about. We're making magical memories with Disney Scene Shore Week.
Sea and Shore Week.
So is it possible to be in the vortex?
There it is. And also this week is going to be my week. It's the Sea and Shore Week. That's what I've been talking about in these videos, is walking in the 1 foot in the water, 1 foot on the land. Good. So I had to keep myself in the vibration then. That was a prophecy, man.
Hills and has this wonderful family and life, but nobody else has the relativity that you have of knowing what true alignment and true open path feels like in relationship to something that's closed off a little bit. So, yes, the vortex, when we speak of this vortex, which is constantly changing, we're talking about you all staying up to speed with the changes. So, the conversation that we had earlier today about, well, this feels better than this and this feels better than this, is always going to be that way. You're never going to reach the place while you are here in this physical form where there is no contrast for you to make a choice. That you've worked the ripples out, and to anyone looking on, you'd look like you're always in the vortex, and to yourself, you would say, well, maybe being in the vortex or out of the vortex isn't exactly this distinction that I'm wanting to make now. Maybe it's more and more alignment, and more and more alignment, and more and more alignment.
Right.
In other words, because a vortex isn't a place, and it really isn't exactly a condition. It's a relationship with who you really are. It's your relationship to your path. And really, oh, we want to say this is what you're reaching for. Thank you very much for being right here. This is the next step in all of this. Since the vortex is not a place, and since the expansion of who you are is eternally ongoing, then rather than talk about being in the vortex, let's just talk about being you don't want and accentuate what you do want. So you do that. You ignore what you don't want and you accentuate what you do want and bump, 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 bump. Because you don't control anybody else's reality. And so we want to ask you, is walking with this person your path of least resistance? And sometimes people will say, well, isn't that what you're teaching us, Abraham? Aren't we supposed to? Aren't we supposed to get so good and get so lined up that our vibration just controls everything around us? And we say, no, that's not what we've been saying. What we've been saying is get lined up, figure out what your path is, and go down that path. We are never saying to you, it's your job to get everybody in the world to vibrate in alignment with what you want. That's not your work. Because the diversity of your planet says everybody's doing their own thing. So the path of least resistance sometimes means making a choice about something that somebody else might not like that just feels better to you. That's, we're just wanting to help you sort of free yourselves to the understanding that you get to choose and that you get better and better at feeling whether your choices are path of least resistance choice or path of more resistance choice.
So with family, I think I have a big effect on other members' reality just because, well, two kids, I tell them to do something and they do it.
they'll be in our meeting later.
No, I have no aspirations of that at all.
They'll say, we gave up our guidance system a long time ago. We just do what our dad says.
But with work as well, and I travel all over the world with work, and so I do affect not direct people's reality, but I mean we're interacting all day, and
yes,
it happens, and then they go off and take what they've learned and
yes,
apply it, and so there is an effect that I have on a lot of realities, I think.
Always. Always. But the thing that we're talking about here, the thing that we really want you to feel, we want you all, somehow today, to find permission for yourself to, in overt ways and more subtle ways, to grant yourself the permission to follow the thought and eventually the inspiration to act that really feels good to you.
Well, that was a short one, so next. It's the San Francisco opening.
Good morning. We are extremely pleased that you are here. It's good to come together for the purpose of co-creating. Do you agree? Co-creation is best here, really. You are knowing what you are wanting. Do you like the feeling of desire? That's such a good thing. If you do, then we're done. Because life will continue to produce it within you. Every day, new clarity, new desire is point of attraction. A point of attraction that is carved out of what you live. So that when you see something that you don't want, something that you do want comes into the forefront in a stronger vibrational way. And you emanate a vibration about that, even if you don't know that you are doing it. If you are in touch with your emotions, you are more aware that you are doing it. But desire is evolving. Your desires are continually being amended. Some new ones are being born. It's a constant, steady process. And the thing that we want to ask you, we really want you to ask yourself, is the thing that you most want to be aware of all other things, or maybe all other things put together, is what am I, we're speaking from your point of view, what am I doing, where do I stand in terms of my mood or attitude or practice thought? What kinds of things do I say and believe in relationship to the new that is born all day, every day? Because you can't stand still. You cannot stop evolving and expanding, because that's what we are all about. You are eternal beings, which means motion forward is a steady part of your experience. But as humans, so often, you want to hold yourself to old beliefs because you think they are more comfortable. But they are not. Old beliefs are not more comfortable because the new you is tugging against them all the time. You expand, and you've got to go with your expansion or you don't feel good. And that's what your emotions are telling you all day, every day. If you feel elation or eagerness, if you're feeling appreciation or happiness or even interest in something, that means you are in the moment with your focus and your attitude and your mood, your vibrational stance right here and now. You're not hindering the expanding you at all. In fact, you're going with the flow of it and you feel great. But if you're angry about something, if you're angry about something, if you're defensive about something, if you are feeling guilty or lonely, if you're feeling any of those emotions, even light ones like frustration, that negative emotion is your indicator that a larger part of you is flowing where you are not going. You have become something because of what life has caused you to focus, but you're not letting yourself be it here and now. You're focused in opposition to who you really are. So that's really what we're all about here. We've been calling this gathering the art of allowing. And it means the art of allowing you to be who you really are. But in order for you to allow yourself to be who you really are, you've got to understand that you're more than this physical body that you recognize or this personality that you know or others know as you. You are source energy. And you were source energy before you came into this body. And this is the thing that most people don't quite get. The largest part of you, that eternal part of you, still is non-physically focused source energy. A part of that energy is focused here with you. But the larger part of you, that expanding part of you, is non-physical consciousness. It's hard to hear that because you know yourself as a physical being. You've got the see it, hear it, smell it, taste it, touch it thing going on. You've got all of this reality around you that you know is real reality. And we say, yes, it is. It's manifested vibration. It is the furthest most vibration that is. But there is a larger part of you that is interested in everything that you're about here and now. And your emotions are your indicator of how well integrated, how much alignment, how much harmony, how much allowance of all that you are you're allowing here and now. Esther watches basketball players, football players, all kinds of magnificent physical accomplishment. And she sees how often the whole of them is there. The part of them that understands aerodynamics, the part of them that has allowed the perfect integration into a physical body, the part of them that is able to calculate in a split second time and space and distance and speed and know what to do in order to accomplish what is on their mind to do. And sometimes she knows they're out of sync and she knows that ball's not going to go in that hoop anytime soon. Not that guy, not today, not the way he's feeling, not what's going on. But often, especially especially emphasized in that arena. There is an understanding of mind over matter. There's an understanding of vibration. There's an understanding of alignment and connection. There's an understanding of being the best that you are. And there's an understanding of pinching the best of yourself off with some mood or opinion or attitude, mostly meanness at yourself, not appreciation of yourself, that can hold you in a vibration that keeps you apart. That's too strong a word. Pinches you off, that's too strong too. Disconnects you, that will never really happen. But in any moment, you have the option of allowing or disallowing, of alignment or resistance, of being tuned in or not being tuned in. You'll never tune out altogether. And just when you think you are, you'll reemerge in the non-physical where you'll really tune back in. In other words, you cannot get away from who you are. But the reason that we like visiting is because we know who you are. We remember why you came. We know that you came for the exhilaration of this moment in time. You came to focus who you are, together with others,